Hello, in this video, I want to talk about the new partnership between Pear Deck and Canva, how you get to these slides, and how you actually make them Pear Deck interactive. First things first, if you don't already have a Canva license, you need to get on that. It's actually free for educators and for all students. You just go to canva.com/education and there you can sign up as a teacher and you'll get 100% free access to many of the features that would be paid if you were not an educator. So you definitely want to take advantage of that. Sign up first. Once you are all logged in, you can go into Canva and you can actually just search for Pear Deck. So if I go back to my main Canva screen and I just type in Pear Deck, you'll be taken to all of the templates that are available. Right now there are 12 templates available. Let's go ahead and click on this today's mood check. So here you'll see that this presentation has 6 different slides. You can go about editing right in Canva itself if you want to tweak anything. So for example, if you're on this slide, if you want to change any of the text, you can do that. If you want to add any images of your own, you can do that. Go to the next slide. Today, I feel I am in the blank zone and it's going to be a draggable question type. However, the interactivity has not been built into Canva. You're going to have to do that step yourself, and I'm going to show you that next. But what they have done is they've suggested what type of question this should be. So this one's a draggable. If I go to the next slide, you'll see that this one they suggested should be a drawing type slide. If I go to the next one, they again suggest draggable. So they might suggest draggable or text or like this one, a drawing type slide. Again, you can edit in Canva. You could add more slides. If you want to add more slides, really take advantage of, then go to Elements and you can take advantage of all the images that are built into Canva. So if I type in exciting, you'll see that some of these say EDU. That means that they would have been locked, but because I'm on an EDU subscription, I have access to it. So you have access to all these things that you see here. So if I click on that, I can pull it in. I can resize it. I can do some formatting, editing here. Also, what I love about Canva is when you pull something in like this, you get the color palette right here. So if you are, say, to add some text, it's going to match the color palette, which is just amazing. I can click on the color and I'll be able to see all the different colors that were actually used throughout my presentation. So there's so many great things to love about designing in Canva itself. Let's go ahead and get this into Pear Deck now. To do that, just click on the 3 dots right here, the menu, and then you can click on Google Drive. If you don't see it in your recommended, I think it's in my recommended because I've used it before, go down to the share, click on the see all, and you would see the Google Drive integration there. If you haven't used it before, I think you'll have to click down there to get started at first. So again, all I did was click on these dots. I go down here. If you go to the share and click on see all, you should definitely find the Google Drive icon. Once you click on that, the first time that you do this, you are going to have to select your Google account. They'll need to sync up and be able to write to your Google Drive. Then you can choose a folder that you want to put it in. And then for the file type, you're going to want to save it as a Microsoft PowerPoint document. It is going to save to your Google Drive, so don't get confused. And then you can choose if you want to select all the pages or just select certain pages. I'm going to select all the pages, press save. At this point, it says your design has been saved. You can just press view in Google Drive. You can also go to your Google Drive itself. You would find it saved there in whatever folder you had saved it in. All right, at this point, these are actually editable. If you need to change anything, you can still do that in the Google Slides itself. This says this file needs to be saved as a .ppx. What I'm gonna do is I'm actually going to just go to File, and I'm gonna save as Google Slides because we want it as a Google Slides, then we'll add the Pear Deck interactivity. Okay, so now it still says .pptx at the end. I'm gonna just delete that because it's not actually a PowerPoint anymore. It's Google Slides. You can tell the difference because if I look back, you can see that this one says the .ppt at the end. That means it's a PowerPoint format versus this one does not say that. So again, the trick there was just go to File and save as Google Slides. If it's already a Google Slides presentation like this one is, you'll see you don't even have that option. Okay, so now we're actually in Google Slides, and now I have my Pear Deck add-on back. So if you go into your add-ons, you'll see you have Pear Deck. So I'm gonna go ahead and open my Pear Deck sidebar. You can do that from your add-ons menu if you don't have the Pear Deck power up add-on on. At this point, I'm gonna go to the slides that should be interactive, and this one should be draggable. So I'm going to choose draggable, and you do have to add it to your slide. So on this one, actually, I should have showed you first. It says drag the star icon. So I wanna make sure that when I choose my draggable that I'm changing it to a star icon, since it says that in the direction. So I'm gonna change it to a star. I think I'll change the color to this dark blue here. And I like the big star, so I'm gonna leave it at that size, update. Now, if this bottom bar gets in your way, it kind of gets on the slide a little bit, you can always move that bottom bar off the screen, and that's fine. It still keeps interactivity. Just make sure that you don't delete this bottom bar, but you can move it off of the slide and it still is attached to that slide. So I'm gonna do that same thing for the other one. So this one is a drawing. So I'm gonna choose drawing. Again, I just want a little bit more space. So I'm gonna move that off the page, go to the next one that says draggable, and this one says place a heart. So I'm gonna go to draggable, and I'm going to choose a heart. And for this one, I actually want my heart to just be bigger. So I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger, and I'm gonna update the slide. And then that was it. There was no more interactivity on the final ones. At this point, I'm ready to start my lesson, and I would just start my lesson like I do any other Pear Deck. Choose either student paste, instructor paste. Let's choose student paste here. Let's go ahead and grab that link and just see what it looks like on the student end. You can see it's a normal Pear Deck on the teacher end. And now for students, we have this really beautifully designed presentation, and it has all of the Pear Deck interactivity that we love. All right, so that's really it. How you're gonna be able to find all these slides later is you can find them in whatever folder you saved them in. So I'm just saving them in a Pear Deck X Canva folder right now. And you'll see that I actually have two versions of this. The reason is because the first one was the PowerPoint version and the second one is a Google Slides. So I'm gonna just delete the PowerPoint version because I do not need that one. I'm really only gonna ever be using the Google Slides one. So you don't need both versions of them saved. So that's it. Can open that up at any point, re-edit it, and again, launch it again with Pear Deck. All right, I hope this quick little tutorial helped and that you'll enjoy using all of the Pear Deck lessons that are designed in Canva by the collaborative team. There's really some great lesson designs here, and then you can customize them to meet your own needs. You can customize them in Canva or in Google Slides, whatever you like best. All right, that'll be it for this video. Bye for now.